A civil society watchdog, the Center for Transparency and Accountability in Liberia, CENTAL, is implementing a 3.5-year National Integrity Building and Anti-Corruption Program in the country. The program seeks to empower citizens with relevant pieces of information to demand for and take action against corruption in Liberia. The program, funded by the government and people of Sweden through the Swedish International Development Corporation, targets 7 counties, including Monserrado, Bong, Nimba, Grand-Bassa, Riverses, Bomi, and Gbapolu. The results of the program can be summed up into 9 key achievable targets: increased knowledge around anti-corruption issues, improved reporting of corruption, better visibility, strengthened relationship with stakeholders, and the establishment of structures. Other areas include increased influence, enhanced commitment to integrity and anti-corruption work, enhanced gender equality, and strengthening the capacity of CENTAL to perform better. The results outlined above were achieved through different program interventions rolled out through 5 key activities: Advocacy and Legal Advice Center, Youth Engagement Program, Integrity Club, Open Expenditure Initiatives, National Integrity Forum, and Communication, Visibility, and Outreach. As the first phase of the program comes to a close, a detailed video documentary shows how an intervention made under the Advocacy and Legal Advice Center helped prevent student Tina Ndobor education from setbacks. Student Tina Ndobor, now an 11th grade student of Adamu International School System, woes began after she claims that her phone was seized by one Mr. Wisse of a previous school. According to her, Mr. Wisse of Early Learning Cooper School started intercepting calls from her phone after he seized it, and when she raised alarm over the behavior of her teacher and complained to her parents. Based on this, Tina's mother visited the campus to ascertain the facts surrounding the phone seizure saga. In the process, Tina's mother and Mr. Wisse had a heated argument that reportedly resulted into a brief tussle between Wisse and Tina's mother. As a result, Wisse, being the principal of the Early Learning Cooper School, expelled Tina on the basis of her mother's action against him. Following her expulsion, Tina opted for a change of school after all efforts by her parents for reconsideration failed. The principal refused to give the student any academic document and even vowed to ensure that she does not enroll at any school within the community. Tina sat and passed the placement exam of the Adamu International School System. Upon admission, Wisse again went after her and asked the school administration not to enroll the student. The extent to which the situation was headed was gradually becoming hopeless and unbearable for Tina's educational sojourn. All efforts to have the matter amicably resolved to grant the student's liberty and her required academic papers failed as months passed by and academic semesters ended. As Tina's academic quagmire continued and not giving up on her quest for education, she kept reaching for other sources of help. Thankfully, Tina heard of CENTAL's Advocacy and Legal Advice Center on one edition of the organization's bi-weekly radio program, Integrity Watch, and the work it does, especially the aspect on giving clients legal help. Without hesitation, Tina informed her mother and reached out to the center on its toll-free number 4432, and the ALAC team swiftly intervened. After several failed mediation efforts, the matter was taken to the Ministry of Education for redress, with CENTAL representing the students and her mother. The ministry ordered the administration of the Early Learning Cooper School through its principal to relinquish the students' required academic documents with immediate effect and drop all claims against her on the basis of her mother's action. The CENTAL ALAC team, represented by the legal officer Anthony Benu Boto, pleaded that the action of former principal against the two students was a transfer of aggression. The intervention helped Tina in gaining all of her required academics documents from the Early Learning Couple School and gain full enrollment at the Albert Mills International School System in her rightful class 11th grade. In this documentary, we will bring you first Mr. Kesi Liwawi, Vice Principal for Administration at the Albert Mills International School System along the Barnesville Road in Gardnersville, followed by students Tina Ndobor as she narrated her ordeal.
Tina Ndobor of the 11th grade class presently enrolled in our school, took the school entrance and make a pass. After the first marking period test, the principal for Early Learning Couple said he learned that she was here. I was in present at the time. She came met my immediate boss, told him that Tina Ndobor of that class is not fit for the class because she didn't get promotion from his school. So my principal said, ah, but then how come? He said, okay, then we speak about it. And my principal sent for Tina Ndobor from the classroom. I asked her, and she spoke about it. He said, but where's your document? She said, the school did not give me anything at all. Because the man always used to be behind me for no reason, talking, he seized my phone, went through my phone, my message box, answering call for me. And because I tried to speak about it, he told me to leave the school. So my principal said, you sure? She said, yes. Then we decided to do a follow-up at the school because we know the principal as well. So we had to call upon him. And he told us that Tina Ndobor did not make a pass. And in her school, she wants to go to your mission, she did not attend there because she did not do well. So she can be fit for the 11th grade. So that we try to get to Tina Ndobor parents. Her mother came here, talked to her mom, said, since there is the situation, Tina will remain home while we are going through the investigation. Tina Ndobor said, oh, then her mom said, about half of our organization that is going through the process. I said, okay, no problem. But since I know Tina from the Boulevard, you know that we're your daughter. But I was working around, talk to my boss so we can see how we can get Tina on board.
Mr. So we said he have the habit of seizing student phone and he would ask you to open the phone. When you open the phone, you will use your phone for the whole day. Then when he sees my phone from me, he said I should open the phone. I said, oh, I can open the phone because my mom sink her inside. He said, when you open the phone, I will expel you. I said, then no problem, let me open the phone. When he carry the phone, I will touch. He said, someone text me now. I'm on the number. Hi, babe. He came to me when I went for the phone. He said, oh, Tina, you in my business now? I said, no, Mr. We said, when you see text that I can be from on Facebook, but don't just conclude. I didn't give the phone. After 1 week, we went back to school. We're in sixth period now. So I and my friends now were playing with the phone. I said, oh, Tina, you're getting father. I said, yeah, we'll close for some time. So we start sharing our phone. And he saw in the class again. He said, give me the phone. In that roller S you're watching? I said, no. I can't be brave and pull roller S on. He said, Tina, give me the phone. I said, Mr. We said, let me open the phone. He said, no, don't open it. Just get rid of it. I said, my mom sink her in her phone. He said, get rid of me. So I gave him the phone. And he carried one when after school for the phone, he took the phone and carried in his sitting room and locked it too. So we come the door, I and my friend Gloria Square. We come the door for a very while, he never opened the door. I have Gloria said, then Tina cool. One when mama said, oh, what the phone? I said, Mr. We said, seize the phone. He said, I really asked we were washing. So when she went, he was soon there. I his sister was there. Sister said, oh, we said went somewhere. She said, all right, when you can't tell him to get the phone to you, because I have phone. My mom doing business for me in the interior. I need to come to the kid well anytime. He get the phone the next day I went to school. He sent me to my sponsor, which is Mohammed Dudu. He said, oh, go to your sponsor will prescribe work for you. So I went out and said I should clean the whole bathroom and wash the camp, each class I should wash the place. I said, I'm a said, how wash that place? And we eat no food on camp. I mean, go home and change. I would offer some friends, they can help me with two. And say, no, when you leave the campus, then you consider yourself out for the school. I said, well, I can be hungry, I do all the work. And you know, since today, I said, so I don't cook no lunch for her. I want to window myself to do which is more than that. He said, oh,
sponsor.
Yeah. When you get the money, when you order to the work, then give me 500. I said, I didn't wait.
500.
Liberty. I said, I didn't get it, and I didn't get you the money. So I went home, and when my mom to get angry, she came back on the campus to him. When she came, luckily, she said she saw him, which is Mr. Mr. We said, Mohammed and the team of students are luscious. I should carry today on in your office. Say, oh, you have to give me the phone because I won't call my mom in the village. He said, you can't get the phone. I take your phone, he started, mama, the old mama explained to me. He took the phone, he started putting it in, he said, my phone costs $250. And your telephone costs $100. So I get to do what they take. So my mom said, send that check, give me either, yeah, a photo back for my child. He said, you get the phone. Mommy went out to go mama and only lap on her with sharp trussle. I had a lap up, or I'm a mom, so mommy, and put him on the table. I didn't get the phone, my mom, bro. So I said, when I'm making an issue happen between us, I will go back to school. I went the next day, the day I will start the access period in SM. He said, I get ready test. I went to school, I called my uncle, started school, my uncle went. In big, he said, I get ready to test because my mom fought him in the office. So I get ready to test. My uncle said, but she was not the one. He said, no. My mom scores my things in the office. So I had left from there. I called my pa, aren't you? When I called him, I said, oh, I said the version here. And they say, you make sure I repeat in free. He said, give me the main number. I gave Mr. Wissel the number to my father. I texted to him. I got into my father and said, call to the good time. We said, I can't saw the call. As soon as he called my name, I can't saw the call. Then he said, all right. Since I had the case looking, I will find time to come there. I said, but time to read against me because my friend is writing the same. I won't get a chance to go again and go read my own. He said, I will come there. 1 week passed. He sent Mr. Suari to our place for I want to come to the statement from me. So Mr. Suari came, he went straight on the campus on new domain. He asked Mr. Wissel, me, Mr. Wissel, yes. He said, well, now they get to the ask, okay, get the test to the get. He said, no, you didn't get the test. Mr. Suari came back, he said, oh, I will test on your campus. I said, I hired him, no, he didn't say, get you the test. So I left there again and called. I said, oh, Papa. The man said, you can get a text. He said, but I sent someone there. I sent Mr. Suari. I'm Mr. Suari, who the phone said, the man can get a text. Exactly that. He said, oh, I wish it to one of our boss the day, which is in the venue, for the kind he left. Few days in the venue came. She came, she came on the campus here to get a statement from me while in class. So I thought, I said, after school, I would bring some document because he said, in the 7th grade, he can prove that in the 7th grade and in the 11th grade, I jumped over class. So when she came on campus here, I was just in class, I said, oh, after school, I'll bring some document and prove that I'm in 7th grade. I'm in 11th grade because I entered the school during my 8th grade year. But I got document from my old school, which is from my frequent costume. I brought it to him, my transcript. I transcribed one of the news like in 7th grade. I said, only if he cared for me as proof. Why in 7th grade? And she said, all right, after school, you should bring it to the office. I carry it to her office. She said, all right, I will go there. It takes time, almost 1 week. TDT, I went in school. We were running after it. When I come, Mr. Doe said, oh, cool, who, my brother? He said he related to the principal of Adam Mill. So don't you get my document again into even my mom pay my school fee in here, I mean in. So Mr. Dodo said I should go home until I can provide documents. I said, but according to you, said I have a small brother. And the thing I have a brother that's new to you, I won't believe. Ah, come on, man. She came on campus with begging me, say, you only send out for today, but tomorrow you're talking in a pain. You are talking me. So I put in a pain. The next day, I asked in the door, she said, Jen, if you will, you know it. In a 1 week to the day, she called me, she said, oh, we finish with
the case.
Alright. You can go back to school, but for that time, it's called, oh, come on, man. Say, oh, the instructor said, she won't come back to school. Ah, it's not in the bin. She said, oh, come back to school. Was me okay, a document, but from that time, you call me for the document.
This documentary comes as an eye-opener to the hundreds. If not, thousands of Tina who are wrongfully undergoing the consequence of transfer aggression and are being denied either access to education, jobs, and other services to take advantage of the center's ALAC services by reaching out today on the toll-free number 4432. Another aspect of this documentary looks at the impact of the National Integrity Building and Anti-Corruption Program on its beneficiaries in the project targeted counties, Monserrado, Bong, Nimba, Grand Bassa, Provosers, Bomi, and Bagolo. We interview beneficiaries to tell their stories about how the project has so far impacted them.
Yeah, Independent National Human Rights, yes, Commission. They didn't do anything. Then the target justice and peace were, yeah, you know, so nothing was done, but he just didn't want to, or probably maybe they were, he was busy, but he had his assistant to come in and speak to him out there. And actually when ALAC went in by, and the evidence that was shown, it just vividly showed that the management of Kiari were at fault. The gentleman that spoke to ALAC could not say on, I mean in the meeting, but off the record, we were able to admit, well, you know, we had to do this, some more we try to keep our job, even though you're doing the wrong thing, yeah. You're doing the wrong thing just because you want to keep your job. And that's something that I just couldn't do. And so that was one. So I really request CENTAL and her partner to go a step further and to be a little robust, go faster. Rather than being slow sometimes and be maybe follow the procedure. But let it be speedy. Doing that can save a life. That would be my recommendation.
When you look at a student, university student must serve very bad, because probably it's not like I can speak English, but I was somehow afraid or cry, I got be training. But since then they came to train me, so they are impacting me. So they have made a lot of impact in my life. I can interact with people whosoever and express myself, and whatever I want to say, I'm free to say or no. Treatment. As a citizen who loves my country, who wants to see my country move forward, I was interested to be part of the club to fight, to help fight against corruption.
You know, we're talking about corruption business. And then people know that since doing our forefathers and corruption behavior, they can see. So it's like in their own mind, there is no way we can get rid of corruption, right? So to kind of to erase that mentality, we needed to talk to them more about, yes, it is true that we can't get rid of it, but we can try to eradicate,
to minimize it,
yeah. So if you as a good citizen in your school or in your class, you notice that this teacher is not doing the right thing, and you as a female, because basically we're focusing on the female, because the female are the one can be into these things, right? They can be experiencing. Sometimes teacher tell you, say,
this extortion.
Yes. So we have to tell them that you as a good citizen, you don't want to see certain things go on, or it's not something that you are in favor of, but because you are under pressure to do it, so you just do it. So you as a good citizen, that's why the people we're working with call CENTAL, they have the ALAC. So ALAC will not, if you call ALAC, we give the numbers. We say if you call ALAC, they will not call your name. They will not expose your identity. They will not say, oh, John Brown called me from this place and they told me this thing. But because we all want a better Liberia and we want to get rid of corruption, They will have your name, your personality, they will have all of your information. They will just, you know, see to what they can do to solve the problem.
Thanks for watching this National Integrity Building and Anti-Corruption Program documentary produced by CENTAL.